voted for Obama.
Thank you very much for calling. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
Good morning. Mccain.
Thank you very much. Line 50. Come on, guys. Turn these things over. I'm blowing through them. You guys need to be as fast as me. Hi, it's MJ. Hello.
Hey.
Hey.
After work for Mccain.
I'm sorry?
Voting after work for Mccain.
Thank you very much. Hi, it's MJ. Who are you voting for? Line 70 there. Hi, it's MJ. Next line. Hello, who's this? I got two voting cold feet people here. They changed their mind.
Yeah, I guess so.
Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
Hello?
Yes, who are you voting for?
I voted early for McCain.
Thanks for the call. I appreciate it. Hi, it's MJ. Yeah. Good morning. Line 4, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Who are you voting for?
Obama, Baba.
Excuse me?
Obama.
Thank you very much. What was it called? Baba, Baba.
Cassie, I'm voting for Sarah Palin.
So, you mean McCain?
Yep.
Thank you. It's MJ. Good morning. Line 12. Hey, the cells are dropping off. People getting cold feet. It's MJ. Good morning.
Good morning.
Voting for whom?
Headed to the polls for McCain.
Thank you very much. Hi, it's MJ. Who are you voting for?
Ralph Nader.
Ralph, we have one Nader.
Do you want to write that down?
Absolutely. We'll put a Nader in there. All right, our first Nader. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
Hi, I'm voting for Obama.
Thank you very much for the call. I'm going to take just a couple more. Guys, stop screening. Whatever is on hold now, whatever you're in the process of screening, finish it up, and we're going to move on here. And we'll get a tally. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
I just voted for Palin.
You mean John McCain with Palin as the vice presidential running back?
Palin.
we'll mark you down as McCain, right?
Yes.
Thank you. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
Hey, McCain, tell you one.
Thank you very much. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
I voted for McCain.
Thank you very much. Hi, it's MJ. Good morning.
Hi, I voted for McCain. What is 10 set?
Thank you very much. Hi. I've got one more hold. All the lines are ringing, but I'm going to do one more screen here. We're going to move on, and we'll pick it up later on. Hi, it's MJ. Who did you vote for?
President McCain.
Thank you very much. All right, there it is. Meredith, where does it stand right now? We're taking random calls. Dana the intern, can you certify that you took random calls as they came in?
Yes, I can.
Thank you. Joey B. also screening. Can you certify that you took random calls as they came in?
Totally random.
As Joey holds on to a 7-Eleven Obama cup.
Yes.
Which I think is the same cup that he just recycled like 8 days in a row.
And Unitard, you also screen calls. Can you certify that you took calls randomly as they came in?
They were all random.
Thank you very much. What do we have? Total?
Obama has 19.
Yep.
And McCain has 47.
47, and then what?
Nader.
What Ralph Nader?
Yep.
Go Nader.
Go Nader.
All right.
Go Nader.
So I read this story last night, MJ.
Yes, Fester.
And I wanted to bring this up to you. Because I think it's very improbable. Can Barack Obama, just like Al Gore, win the popular vote, but lose the Electoral College?
Well, the way the Electoral College is, and that is possible because the Electoral College, they cast, you know, the vote based on generally popular vote. And historically, it generally always follows the popular vote, how the electoral votes go in each particular state, but there have been cases where it hasn't gone that way. So what does it say? It's a nightmare scenario for Democrats. Their nominee, Barack Obama, winning the popular vote, while Republican John McCain ekes out an electoral college victory. Sure, McCain trails in every recent national poll. Sure, surveys show that Obama leads in the race to reach the requisite. Oh, by the way, how many electoral votes do you need to lock it in, Meredith? Meredith, listen to me. I'll give you $1,000 cash right now. $1,000. Hey,
what?
Stop. Okay. Joey B, if you help her out, I'll gouge her eyes off with a melon scoop.
All right, I'm sorry.
Ouch. Here we go. Meredith, $1,000. I'll write you a check right now. How many electoral votes do you need to clinch?
I'm going to go with 4.
Just
go now.
Good guess, Meredith. 4?
I don't know.
I just found out Meredith has yet to know where she has to vote today, where she has to go.
I have no idea where to vote.
You don't know where to vote?
No, because remember I moved here like a year ago. I changed my address, but they never sent me my little card in the mail.
So, you wouldn't call the supervisor of elections?
I'm going to look it up online later.
Today?
I'm going to go online and look at my...
Hold on.
to the public